I am Evija Ērkšķe, representing Zemgale planning region. With the ENGRAVE project, our institution was lucky, together with external experts from University of Latvia, to develop Zemgale region landscape and green infrastructure plan. This kind of plan is very unique for the situation of Latvia from the context of the scale and also the context. The plan was developed during very short period of time, 1 year, and based on the methodology which was also developed during the ENGRAVE project about landscape and green infrastructure planning in a local and regional scale in the territories of lowland rivers. For the plan, there has been developed also the short version of it in a brochure, and more detail about this plan you will see in the following presentation.
Landscape and green infrastructure plan for Zemgale planning region is designed as the assessment of the landscape and green infrastructure in year 2019, outlining actions and governance solutions to enhance landscape qualities. This plan has been developed according to the developing documents of Zemgale planning region, including the development program for 2015 to 2020 and strategic priorities as the first one, integrated planning, which contains the task ensure integrated landscape management at regional and local levels. By performing Zemgale planning region landscape inventory and integrated results into planning documents, and by developing a landscape ecological plan for Zemgale planning region, potentially for the whole region, but as a priority area is the Zemgale plain. Landscape ecological plan should be developed integrating ecological and social economic aspects of landscape management proposals. Landscape policy in Latvia is based on the international document agreement European Landscape Convention, ratified by Saeima in 2007, and the consequential landscape policy guidelines for 2013-2019, developed by the Ministry of Environmental Protection and Regional Development. The European Landscape Convention landscape definition emphasizes that landscape is both a territory and also its perception. Landscapes are formed over a long period of time, and landscapes should be defined both by locals and also landscape visitors. Here you can see the key issues of the thematic plan, which include the recommendations for landscape assessment and planning at the regional scale, the use of ecosystem services approach to assess the state of the green infrastructure, moreover also the identification of landscape quality objectives and place-based solutions, development of green infrastructure scenarios at the sub-regional level, as well as recommendations for landscape governance at the regional level. A special unit of a landscape as region, sub-region and area is a scale-dependent territorial unit that is similar in terms of its structure, functions, visual form, course of historical development. For Zemgale planning region, landscape classification were used two approaches, typological and territorial. Landscape regions are defined by two main characteristics. Land forms and land cover use mosaic. Natural conditions such as relief forms, soils and water conditions play an important role in the use of the territory and the formation of the landscape. They form the basis of the spatial structure and the landscape. Landscape subregions mark functionally homogeneous landscape units at the regional scale. These landscape units are distinguished based on similar land use types and territorial belonging, including territorially united areas of valuable landscape elements. Within the plan has been assessed also the ecosystem services supply potential in Zemgale planning region, which are divided into four categories. Regulating ecosystem services are of particular importance to human well-being, such as climate control, pollution reduction, protection against erosion. Provisioning ecosystem services are those from which directly benefit people and for which market value can be established, such as forage, herbs, genetic resources. Cultural ecosystem services promote personal growth, knowledge, aesthetic enjoyment and relaxation, such as landscape and its aesthetic qualities and cultural heritage providing basis for recreation and tourism and quality of life in the area. In order to find out in which areas ecosystem services are inadequately provided and therefore in which areas planning of green infrastructure is required, hot and cold spot analysis has been carried out, which reveals a probability of a territory unit, 0.1 to 1 kilometer, to fall into the cold category when there is a short in regulating ecosystem services, or in the hot category when regulating ecosystem services are provided to a great extent. The results of the analysis show that there is a lack of regulating ecosystem services in intensive agricultural areas and major populated areas as towns and cities, which are thus to be classified as a priority areas for green infrastructure planning. In the plan has been carried out also the evaluation of hydrology, aquatic resources, fish and bird species in the Lielupe River Basin. Data and research on river and lake water quality assessment showed that a large part of the catchment area is subject to diffuse and point-to-farm pollution as well as transboundary pollution. In the lower and middle reaches of the Lielupe River, there are typical limnophilic species like pike, perch, rudd, line, etc., which show the impact of the freshwater ecosystem of Lake Babīte on the formation of the ichthyofauna of the Lielupe River. Bird species with those distribution is closely related to the Zemgale plain are rook, collared dove, ortolan bunting, grey partridge, common quail, common moran, European turtle dove and common linnet. The landscape region of Zemgale plain has been selected as the area of deep stated research, the area where the ecosystem service analysis identified the largest trade-offs between the provisioning and regulating ecosystem services. The statistical analysis of hot spots showed the densest cold spots distribution within it. Intensive farming practices have significantly altered the natural conditions in the plain, while the major consequences of intensive farming are water pollution and eutrophication, soil degradation, soil wind erosion, and the decline of diversity as a result of insecticides. Thank you for your attention. If you have any questions regarding the Zemgale Regional Landscape and Green Infrastructure Plan, you are welcome to reach me on the provided contacts, phone number and email. Thank you.